Good day, church. My name is Tinley Dhani Oluleye. I'm from John 121, Ikorodu, Lagos. I'm 6 years old, and I want to recite to you Jesus through the entire Bible. As you listen, Mary, may you bless in Jesus' name. In Genesis, Jesus Christ is the breath of life. In Exodus, is our Passover lamb. In Leviticus, is our high priest. In Deuteronomy, is the prophet like unto Moses. In Joshua, is the captain of our salvation. In Judges, is our judge and our giver. In Ruth, is our kinsman redeemer. In 1st and 2nd Samuel, is our trusted prophet. In Kings and Chronicles, is our reigning king. In Esther and Nehemiah, is the rebuilder of broken down walls of human life. In Esther, is our Mordecai. In Job, is our ever-living redeemer. In Psalms, is our shepherd. In Proverbs and Ecclesiastes, is our wisdom. In Songs of Solomon, is our loving bridegroom. In Isaiah, is the Prince of Peace. In Jeremiah, is the righteous branch. In Lamentation, is the weeping prophet. In Hosea, is the faithful husband, forever married to the backsliders. In Joel, is the baptizer of the Holy Ghost and fire. In Amos, is our body bearer. In Obadiah, is the mighty to save. In Jonah, is the great foreign missionary. In Micah, is the messenger of beautiful feet. In Nahum, is our strength and shield. In Habakkuk, is God's evangelist. In Zephaniah, is our savior. In Haggai, is the restorer of God's lost heritage. In Zechariah, is the fountain opened up in the house of David for sin and uncleanness. In Malachi, is the son of righteousness, rising with healing in his wings. In Matthew, Jesus Christ is the King of the Jews. In Mark, is our servant. In Luke, is the son of man, feeling what you feel. In John, is the son of God. In Acts, is the savior of the world. In Romans, is the righteousness of God. In 1 Corinthians, is the rock that followed Israel. In 2 Corinthians, is the triumphant one giving victory. In Galatians, is your liberty. He sets you free. In Ephesians, is the head of the church. In Philippians, is your joy. In Colossians, is your completeness. In 1st and 2nd Thessalonians, is your hope. In 1st Timothy, is your faith. In 2nd Timothy, is your stability. In Titus, is truth. In Philemon, is your benefactor. In Hebrews, is your profession. In James, is the foundation of your faith. In 1st Peter, is your example. In 2nd Peter, is your purity. In 1st John, is your life. In 2nd John, is your pattern. In 3rd John, is your motivation. In Jude, is the foundation of your faith. And in Revelation, He is your coming King. He's the first and the last, the beginning and the end. He's the keeper of creation and the creator of all. He's the architect of the universe and the manager of all times. He always was, he always is, he always will be. Unmoved, unchanged, unfeared and never undone. He was bruised and brought healing. He was pierced and his pain. He was dead and brought life. He was persecuted and brought freedom. He reigns and brings power. He reigns and brings peace. The world can't understand him. The armies can't defeat him. The schools can't explain him. And the leaders can't ignore him. Herod couldn't kill him. The Pharisees couldn't confuse him. Herod couldn't crush him. Islam couldn't silence him. The new age couldn't replace him. He's alive, love, longevity and more. His goodness, kindness, gentleness and God. He's holy, righteous, mighty, powerful and pure. His ways are right and his word is eternal. His will is unchanging, his mind is on me. He's my redeemer, he's my savior, he's my comfort, he's my peace, he's my joy, he's the eternal rock of ages, he's the God of MFM, and he rules my life. Thank you.
God bless you.